Here comes the math. Don't be afraid, you can do it. All right, take a look at this. We just set this up. Here's our diagram, orographic lifting. Here's the first thing we do. So, the air at sea level is 72 degrees. It's going to rise up the sides of the mountain to 6,000 feet, where it's going to reach its condensation level. How many thousands of feet is that air rising up from zero to 6,000 feet? How many thousands of feet is it going up from zero to 6,000? Answer is 6,000 feet. So what do? We've already established that we're going to use the DAR, the dry adiabatic rate. So we take 5.5, which is the dry adiabatic rate, times 6 for 6,000 feet, because it's already in thousands. 5.5 times 6 is 33 degrees. Then you just ask yourself this question. At 6,000 feet, is that air warmer or colder than it was at sea level? And of course, the answer is colder. So what do? You take 72 degrees, the given, down there at sea level, minus 33, because that's how many degrees the air has changed as it rose from 0 to 6,000 feet. 72 minus 33 is 39 degrees, which tells you now that the temperature of that rising parcel at its condensation level, where it first reaches 100% relative humidity, is 39 degrees. Okay, next part. The air continues to rise up the windward side of this mountain. It's going from 6,000 up to 11,000 feet. How many thousands of feet is it going up if it's going from 6,000 to 11,000 feet? Answer is 5,000. Excellent. And now we're going to multiply this by the WAR, which we already established, because there's a cloud forming. And clouds mean 100% relative humidity. So we take 3.3, the WAR, times 5 for 5,000 feet. Between 6,000 and 11,000 is 5,000 feet. 3.3 times 5 is 16.5 degrees. Then we're going to take 39 degrees, which is the temperature at 6,000 feet, and subtract 16.5 degrees from it. 39 minus 16.5 is 22.5 degrees. So now we know at 11,000 feet, the temperature of that rising parcel is 22.5 degrees. If something was coming out of the clouds at 11,000 feet, is that going to be snow or rain? Good, snow. Now the air is going to descend from 11,000 down to 3,000 feet on the leeward side. We already know that every time air descends, we use the DAR. So whatever we get, we're going to multiply by 5.5. How many thousands of feet is that parcel of air subsiding from 11,000 down to 3,000 feet? Answer is 8,000. So we take 5.5, the DAR, times 8 for 8,000 is 44. But because the air is descending, it's warming up. So this time we're going to add. So we take 22.5 plus 44 is 66.5 degrees. And now we know that at 3,000 feet on the leeward side, that parcel of air is 66.5 degrees. That's the math. But here's what you should also be able to discern. What the relative humidity is at 6,000 feet on the windward side? What the relative humidity is 11,000 feet on the windward side. What the relative humidity is at 8,221 feet and 6 3/4 inches on the windward side. Yep. What the dew point temperature is at 6,000 feet on the windward side. What the dew point temperature is at 11,000 feet, the top of the mountain. And where the relative humidity is higher, 8,000 feet on the leeward side or 6,000 feet on the leeward side, and why? Let's go through it. All right, let's start with this. This is not hard. The relative humidity at 6,000 feet on the windward side. Well, is there a cloud forming or not? The answer is yes. 6,000 feet is the condensation level. Condensation. Get the terminology here? So if there's a cloud forming, what is the relative humidity Have to be. Answer is 100%. Very good. All right. What about the relative humidity at 11,000 feet? Let's assume the cloud is up here. The cloud is actually at 11,000 feet. If the cloud is at 11,000 feet, what's the relative humidity? 100%. How about this one? I know this one seems wacky, but it's not wacky at all. What is the relative humidity at 8,221 feet and 6 3/4 inches on the windward side? In other words, right about there. What is the relative humidity? Well, just ask yourself, is there a cloud forming? We know there's a cloud forming every place from 6,000 to 11,000 feet. Every place, any number I'd give you in there's a cloud, which means the relative humidity has to be 100%. All right, what about the dew point temperature at 6,000 feet on the windward side? Well, remember, when the relative humidity is 100%, we also know two other things because these three things always go together hand in glove. Here's what they are. If the relative humidity is 100%, we also know the air is saturated. If we know the air is saturated, we also know that the air temperature and the dew point temperature must be the same number. There is no vegetarian option on this menu. And as a result of that, if we know the relative humidity is 100% at 6,000 feet on the windward side, and we know the air temperature is 39 degrees, that means we also know the dew point temperature must be 39 degrees. Yeah! What about at 11,000 feet, the top of the mountain? Well, is there a cloud? Yes! If there's a cloud, the relative humidity is 100%. If the relative humidity is 100%, the air is saturated. If the air is saturated, the air temperature and the dew point temperature have to be the same number, which means the dew point temperature must be 22 and a half degrees, which is exactly what it is. Good. What about this? Where is the relative humidity higher, 8,000 feet or 6,000 feet on the leeward side? Notice that I just put those numbers on there for you, 8,000 to 6,000 feet. Well, we know at the top of the mountain there's a cloud. It's 100% relative humidity. And we know the air is descending. And we know this also. When the air is descending, it's warming. And we also know, because of what we studied with relative humidity, as air temperature goes up, relative humidity goes down. And as that air parcel is descending that mountain, it's getting warmer and warmer and warmer, which means it's getting drier and drier and drier. This is why deserts are found on the leeward sides of mountains, because the air gets very dry. There's no clouds, no clouds, no precipitation, no precipitation, no vegetation. See the way that works? You can tell I'm from the LBC because it all rhymes. And so what that means is this: as that air is descending, the relative humidity is of course going to be highest at 11,000 feet. And then at 11,000 feet, it's higher than it is at 8,000 feet. At 8,000 feet, it's higher than it is at 6,000 feet. At 6,000 feet, it's higher than it is at 3,000 feet. So the answer to our question, where is the relative humidity higher at 8,000 or 6,000 feet on the leeward side? The answer is 8,000 feet. Yeah! Want to see that cloud again? Take a look at that. So now we know down here, this would all be DAR. And then everything up here, WAR, 100% relative humidity.